Today we are going to study capillary action, which in other words is also called as capillarity. And in physics we know whenever ITY, like elasticity, viscosity, density, word comes in the last like suffix of any English word, then that becomes a property. So capillarity is a property of liquids such that if they can rise or fall in a tube having a very fine bore. So if any tube made up of any material, not necessarily glass, has very fine bore, approximately 1 millimeter, then that is open at both the ends. Suppose this is a tube, it is open at both the ends A as well as B, and it has very fine bore. Bore means its internal diameter where the liquid can stand, then this tube is called as a capillary tube. So the complete definition will be a tube having a very fine bore and open at both ends is called a capillary tube. So suppose we are taking a case in which this is fluid, liquid. Suppose over here we are taking water. This trough has water, and as previously we have studied that near the walls water surface becomes concave because adhesive forces are much stronger as compared to the adhesive forces. And as we go on towards the middle of the water surface, the surface becomes exactly plane. Now in this condition, if we dip a capillary tube in this water, then inside the capillary, water will rise up and it will maintain a certain height. Ek height par jaakar water standing condition mein aa jayega. Is capillary ke andar bhi surface concave hi hoga. So this extra height is called as h, and this height is extra than the outside liquid surface. So this is with the help of capillary. Now in the second example we have studied that mercury type liquids does not wet the glass surface and the free liquid surface is convex like this. So this is mercury in a glass trough. Now when we dip the same capillary inside this mercury, then this liquid surface is depressed and mercury comes here, and now the surface will be settled as this surface becomes convex like this, becomes convex like this, this surface becomes convex like this. This is by the adjustment of molecular forces, and mercury is depressed or falls in the capillary tube. So the depth of depression of mercury from the outside mercury level is called as the fall in the capillary tube. So we can see that with water and glass pair, the level rises in the capillary tube, and with mercury and glass pair, the mercury level falls in the tube. which is also called as depression in the capillary tube. So again, we will revise the concept of capillary tube. So a tube which has very fine bore, approximately 1 millimeter, and which is open at both the ends is called a capillary tube. Next, we have the definition of capillarity, as this indicates there is a property. So the phenomena of rise or fall of a liquid inside a capillary tube when the capillary tube is dipped in the liquid is called capillarity. For example, we have just seen in the previous definition that when we take the pair of water and glass, water rises in the capillary tube and hence we get extra height of water surface. Now if we are taking mercury and glass pair, mercury makes convex surface with the glass as well as inside the capillary, so the liquid level will fall. Hence we can say that mercury falls below the normal level outside the capillary tube. Hence now we will say that what is the quantitative argument, because for this rise or extra fall, so this expression is called as the reason for capillary fall. So we may write a question for this. Explain reasons for capillarity on the basis of pressure difference. So this is a board question which comes in broad category questions. So let's take first reason why mercury falls in a capillary tube. So for the discussion, we have taken everywhere the convex surface whenever mercury touches the solid walls. Now we are taking four points, point A, point B, point C and point D, such that the description of each point in the figure is implicit. Point A is just above the convex surface, but it is inside the capillary. Point B is just below the convex surface inside the capillary. Point C is just above the plane surface. As we can see, the middle surface becomes plane, but it is outside the capillary. And point D is just below the plane surface and it is also outside the capillary, and it is exactly below the point C. So we can take the pressure at point A as PA, pressure at point B as PB, pressure at point C as PC and pressure at point D as PD. Now if we compare the pressures at points A and B, we know that pressure on the concave side is always greater. Therefore, we can take first argument as pressure on B is greater than pressure on A. This makes reason number one, that is equation number one. Now, points A and point C are at the same horizontal level in air, therefore the pressure at both these points will be equal and that will be the atmospheric pressure itself. So we can take second reason as pressure at point A is equal to pressure at point C. This is reason number two. Now when we compare points C and D, we can take the surface in between points C and D as plane liquid surface, and we have studied already that if the liquid surface is plane, there is zero pressure difference. So it means pressure at point C is same as pressure at point D, and by equation 2 we can extend this transitive relationship that it is also equal to pressure at point A. So this becomes our reason number 3. Now we can see from these three equations that if we put PD in place of PA in equation number 1, then we can get, you can write the reason, PD put in equation 1 in place of PA. So PA ke place par aap PD put kar rahe hain because PA aur PD ka pressure same hai. So this equation 1 is modified to PB is greater than PD, that is pressure at D point is greater, PB is more, and pressure at D point means PD is less. But this is the strange thing, because B and D are also at the same horizontal level, but at point B pressure is more. And we have studied always, the liquid tries to set up the equilibrium, hence liquid will flow from high pressure to low pressure. So in order to maintain the same pressure at both the points, the mercury in this capillary tube rushes out of the capillary, and hence this point B wants to set up an equilibrium with point D. So if it falls at level, mercury level, then it can gain a pressure same as that of D. Hence mercury inside the capillary tube will fall, and therefore we will be getting the modified diagram as this is capillary tube. Due to this pressure difference, the level will be like this, and inside the capillary there will be fall. Molecule B comes by h distance in the downward direction, and this was original mercury level. So now again we can take those four points C, and this is D. This is D because point B or the particle B comes downward, and hence this is the reason for capillary fall in the case of mercury and glass. Now in second case, we will be taking the reason whenever any liquid rises in the capillary tube. For example, the great and simple example is the pair of water and glass. So let's take again the case here. This is a beaker. So this was the figure when we have just immersed capillary in water. So this is a figure when capillary is just immersed in water. This is very instantaneous position. Now we are again taking four particles or four points. A is just above the liquid surface but inside the capillary. B is just below the liquid surface inside the capillary. C is a point which is at the same level of A point but it is outside the capillary above the free liquid surface, and D is a point which is just below the point C and it is inside the liquid on the flat surface side. So again we are comparing the pressure of point A and B. So as we can see that A lies on the concave side, therefore the very first point will be pressure on A will be greater as pressure on B. This is reason number 1. Now when we compare point A and C point, because they are at the same horizontal level, so both are experiencing the atmospheric pressure due to air. So we can say the second reason as PA equal to PC. Now when we compare points C and D, because both are on the opposite sides of this horizontal liquid surface or the flat liquid surface, so pressure on both sides will be same and there will be zero pressure difference. So for these two points we can say that PC equal to PD, pressure is same, and since PC equal to PA, therefore we can say here this is PA. So we have three reasons. This was reason number two and this is reason number three. Now when we put this PA equal to PD in equation number one, we get that after some time or after equilibrium, PD is greater than PB. So when we compare these two points, PD means over here the pressure will be more and over here at B point the pressure is less. So this liquid molecule want to go towards the less pressure, hence the liquid molecule goes to this side, this liquid molecule goes to this side, and hence it increases the level of liquid inside the capillary tube, and hence there is a rise in the case of capillary when water wets the glass surface and angle of contact is acute as well as the surface is concave. In the previous diagram of mercury and glass surface, in the inside point the pressure was more, therefore the mercury was rushing out from high pressure to the low pressure, high pressure to the low pressure, hence mercury level falls in the capillary tube. Hence this process in the case of mercury was called as capillary fall. Now these are some practical examples of capillarity, where in daily life how can we find the capillarity. So in the first case, when we give water to the plants, so this is water given to the fields, hence rises in innumerable capillaries which are formed in the stems of plants and trees and reaches the branches and the leaves. Because first example is against the gravity, when sap rises in the plants, it means anything going against gravity. In second example, when we use lanterns, there is a wick. Wick means usme jo patla sa thread hota hai, jo ancient time mein lanterns use hote the, usme kerosene oil gravity ke against rise hota hai. So that is again the case of rise in the capillaries formed in cotton, wick and burns. Next, in third example, bathing ke baad towel use kiya jata hai. So if one end of a towel is dipped in water filled in a vessel, then water begins to rise in the innumerable holes which act like capillaries formed in between the threads of the towel, and ultimately entire towel is wetted. Similarly, this case happens in the case of fine cotton cloth. Next, in fourth example, coffee powder is easily soluble, or you may take example of Bonvita powder, because water immediately wets the fine granule of coffee by the action of capillarity. So in rainy season also we check that coffee granules stick with each other because due to moisture, and that is also by the action of capillarity. Now in fifth example, we are taking blotting paper case. In blotting paper, if we put a dot of ink pen or just the nib of ink pen, complete blotting paper shows that the ink is spreading very, very fast. Because the reason is blotting paper is porous and it has innumerable capillaries. So when an ink dot is placed on blotting paper, the ink rises in those capillary tubes, that is fine holes. Hence, we cannot write on blotting paper. It is also for this reason that wet glass plate can be wiped by a towel but not by silk or nylon, because a towel cloth has very fine innumerable capillaries. Now in the sixth example, writing nib in the ink pen is split in the middle so that a fine capillary is formed in it, and when this ink pen is dipped in ink, then that ink rises in the capillary tubes. In next example, where farmers plow their fields after rains so that the capillaries formed in the soil are broken, because पहले से काफ़ी capillaries बनी होती हैं और plowing करने के बाद वो capillaries break हो जाएंगी, and hence water will be taken by the plants, and if plowing is not done, then वो जो water था lower layers का वो capillaries में rise होता रहेगा, एंड देन फिर वो लीव्स के एंड पर आकर इवेपरेट हो जाएगा. सो देयर फोर आफ्टर रेन्स प्लॉइंग इज नेसेसरी फॉर द फील्ड्स. इज डिराइव एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर कैपिलरी राइज और फॉल, मीन्स कितना एक्स्ट्रा वाटर या लिक्विड राइज हुआ और कितना लिक्विड इन केस ऑफ मर्करी एंड ग्लास फॉल हुआ, एंड बाय how much height, that we have to find out, which is also called as ascent formula. Whenever the question, broad question is asked, that derive an expression for ascent formula or descent formula, we can use always two methods. First method uses the concept of pressure difference. As we know that pressure on the concave side of liquid surface is always greater than on the convex side. And the second method of this is using different type of forces in consideration with the liquid. So in short, we should remember ascent formula just from now, then we will be starting the derivation. Ascent formula, where extra height or fall h is equal to 2t cos theta divided by r rho g, where the symbols are h is the rise or fall of liquid inside the capillary, t is the surface tension of liquid, theta is the angle of contact. Now for concave type surfaces, angle will be acute, and for convex type surfaces, angle will be obtuse. R is the radius of capillary tube. Rho is the density of liquid which rises or falls inside the capillary. And G as usual is acceleration due to gravity. So before going to both the derivation, let us understand the meaning of radius of capillary tube as well as the radius of meniscus. So first, understanding two terms, radius of capillary tube is denoted by small r, and radius of curvature of meniscus is denoted by capital R. Now this is a liquid and which is filled in the capillary tube. This is point of contact. It is also point of contact. It makes a limitation in the case of 2D figure. Otherwise, if we would be observing this liquid in a bottle, everywhere we will be getting the points of contact where the liquid touches the solid surface. So let's we are taking this as means the distance from this point to the center of the capillary tube as the radius of capillary tube, because this hole is the diameter of capillary tube. Now as we will complete this sphere or the curvature in the form of complete sphere, then so this is small r, that is radius of capillary tube. Now when I have plotted the imaginary sphere, let's assume we get the center of this imaginary sphere at this point. Now from here, if we join the point of contact, this gives us capital R, which is the radius of curvature of meniscus denoted by capital R. Now this is the point of contact, hence at this we can draw the tangent. So this will be the angle of contact between the tangent at the point of contact and the solid surface on the side of the liquid. So by geometry, this angle is also theta. This triangle is completed and this angle is also theta. So taking the ratio of small r and capital R in terms of cos theta, we get cos theta equals to base divided by hypotenuse. So base is small r and hypotenuse is capital R. Therefore we can say that capital R is equal to small r divided by cos theta. So this is very important relationship between radius of meniscus and the radius of the capillary tube, because for the significant sense, radius of capillary tube can be measured, but the radius of meniscus cannot be measured. So in the first type, when we will find capillary rise formula or ascent formula by using the pressure difference method, we will be using this relationship. So let's go to the capillary rise formula derivation using pressure difference method. In first derivation type, we will derive capillary rise or fall formula using pressure difference formula. As just in the previous discussion, in the relationship of small r and capital R, we have seen that inside the capillary tube, either the liquid surface will be concave or the liquid surface will be convex, moreover in the case of mercury and glass surface. So always the pressure on the concave side will be greater, and suppose we are taking this point as A and this point as B. Now what is the pressure difference in A and B points? This is equal to 2T divided by R. But as this liquid is also contained in this container, so when this liquid pillar goes above side or as compared to the other liquid surface in the trough containing liquid surface, this liquid column should be supported by a pressure or by a force which can give it strength. So if the height of this liquid column is H, the pressure it will be standing with H rho G by the formula of hydrostatic pressure. So we can take H rho G is the supporting pressure. This is equal to 2T divided by R. So we can get the expression for height H equal to 2T divided by R rho G. But as in the previous discussion we have seen, when we complete this imaginary sphere or the meniscus part, this open surface of liquid is called as meniscus, which is in contact with air, then we will be getting a center. So that radius is called as radius of meniscus. But we could not know this radius of meniscus, and we know the value of radius of capillary tube. And over here we took the relationship just in the previous derivation that capital R is expressed as small r divided by cos theta, where small r is the radius of capillary tube. So using this capital R value in this derivation, we get h equal to 2t divided by small r divided by cos theta. So cos theta will go to numerator, and over here we get rho into g in the denominator by previous step. So we get ascent formula as h equal to 2t cos theta divided by r rho g. Now if the liquid surface is concave, then theta will be acute. It means it will be in the first quadrant. Hence this theta will be acute and the value of cos theta will be greater than 0. But in the case of liquid which does not wet the solid surface, theta will be obtuse. Hence this theta will lie in the second quadrant, and in second quadrant the value of cos theta is less than 0. So this will express that h is negative. So negative h means there is fall in the capillary tube, and this cos theta is positive. So this positive value of cos theta will be giving positive value of h. It means there is rise in the capillary tube. So in this case, when cos theta is negative, the meniscus will be convex, and in the first case when the angle of contact is acute, the meniscus will be concave. Now we will go on the second method, which is using forces. So when we are taking a liquid surface as in the concave shape inside the capillary tube, according to the limitation of 2D figure, we are getting only two points of contact in this plane of paper. So over here, suppose we are taking this point of contact, then we can draw this tangent at this curve, and along this tangent the force due to surface tension is acting, and again according to this point of contact the force due to surface tension will be acting along this direction. Now this is point of contact, hence these two are vertically opposite angles. So this is also point of contact. So we can break this force due to surface tension. Let's represent this force as Ft, because T is only surface tension. This force due to surface tension as F subscript T. So this component with theta is called as Ft cos theta, and this component is Ft sin theta. Similarly, on this side, this is angle of contact on the side of liquid. So these two are vertically opposite angles. This is also theta. So this corresponding component, base component, is F T cos theta, and this will be F T sin theta. Now all F T sin theta are emerging out from the container from different points of contact, so they will be found in pairs, hence will cancel each other. But the extra liquid column is supported by this force F T cos theta. So for equilibrium's sake, we can see that Ft cos theta is supporting extra weight of liquid, so that is equal to mg. Now m cannot be measured. Whatever extra liquid rises in the capillary tube cannot be measured, but it can be expressed as density into volume into small g. Now To find the force due to surface tension, we take the product of surface tension as well as the length. This formula we have already practiced. Now the length in contact with the solid surface, the complete length, is called as 2 pi r, where small r is the radius of capillary tube. So this will be T into 2 pi r cos theta equal to rho will be given for the liquid. Volume of this extra liquid is area of cross section into height. This is the volume A into H. So cancelling the other data, we can get that the surface tension is obtained as T equals to R H rho G divided by 2 cos theta, or we can express the ascent formula as H equal to 2T cos theta divided by R rho G. So this is the final expression for height. It is also valid for capillary fall, which is discussed earlier. Now, in the given numerical, calculate the height to which water density is given 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube, that is rho, will rise in a capillary tube of 1 mm diameter. So radius will be half. The angle of contact is 0, so theta is 0, and surface tension of water is given. I have put different datas like values, and then using the ascent formula, H equals to 2T cos theta divided by R rho G, putting different values. Now you should calculate the value of H. In second question, a glass capillary tube is given. The radius will be 0.25 mm divided by 2. Density is rho given and extra height is given, h 2.8 centimeter, and theta is 17 degree. So we have to find surface tension of liquid. Again, I have put all the values, and so the formula for surface tension is r h rho g divided by 2 cos theta, which is same as the ascent formula. Just transferring of terms here and there. So putting all the values, you may calculate the value of surface tension. Just take care of the units and powers of 10 in each problem. In third numerical, according to question, we have to find out the height by ascent formula. Radius will be 0.5 mm divided by 2. And capital T equals to 7 into 10 to the power minus 2 newton per meter. Angle is not given, therefore we will assume it as 0. This question, again the values I have converted just in proper units. So 0.5 mm can be written as, removing this decimal, 5 into 10 to the power minus 4 by 2, because this was diameter given in meter, and surface tension is 7 into 10 to the power minus 2 newton per meter given in the question. Hence we can take ascent formula again. Whenever theta is not given to us, we can take cos 0 degree equal to 1, because for pure water theta is 0 degree. And density of water as 1000 kg per meter cube. So try to solve it by yourself. Now over here in fourth question, two tubes, namely A and B, are given. They are dipped in a liquid. The heights in respective tubes are 2.8 cm and 4.2 cm. So we can assume them as H1 and H2. And R1 is given, and we have to find out R2. Present question is of slightly different type, where two capillaries of different bores, that is of different diameters, are given. Hence, if the diameters are different, the heights will be different. As we can see by this formula of surface tension, that if these quantities remain constant, then the product of radius as well as height will remain constant. So we can take it as R into H equal to constant. So for the first case of capillary, we can take it R1H1 equal to R2H2. Now putting these values at the proper place, we can find the second radius of capillary tube. So practice more and more numericals, and in next session we will be doing more numericals of slightly difficult type. So thanks till then.